Hello everyone. It's too bad we can't meet physically for a while, but it's really great that this virtual get together is happening. I've been asked to say something about the origins of the NWMI. This is particularly for the benefit of the many members who've joined the network recently and haven't had the opportunity so far to attend any of the annual national meetings. I'd just like to say two things about how this unique, now nearly 19-year-old network came about. First of all, the idea emerged from many of the women journalists across the country that I had interviewed in the late 1990s, who said it was time we had some kind of a forum for media women in India. At that time, there were a few local groups in various places, but nothing at the national level. So the network building process that began in November 2000 was undertaken in response to a felt need. Secondly, the entire process was a bottom-up one, with three regional meetings held in different parts of the country, Bangalore, Jaipur, and Shillong, to figure out the if, what, why, and how of creating a network. The women from several states working in different languages who came together during those initial meetings immediately and enthusiastically endorsed the idea of linking up. It was on the basis of that collective approval that the first national meeting of Indian women in media was held in Delhi in January 2002. An average of 100 women journalists participated in that initial three-day meeting, approximately 60 having traveled from 16 places in 14 states. Journalists working in at least a dozen languages were present. The network became a reality at the end of 3 days of intense discussion and debate that eventually led to decisions based on consensus. The history and evolution of the network has been fairly extensively documented on the NWMI website. I hope all of you will check out the website, which has recently been revamped, if you haven't already. And that some of you will also volunteer to help out with the site and or get involved in the several other initiatives of the network. As you may know, and if not, will no doubt gather today, everything the network is and does is entirely dependent on volunteers.
Hi, NWMers. It's wonderful to be able to connect like this at the end of the year. What a terrible year, but let's hope that next year, 2021, that we will actually meet in person and celebrate the way we always have. So I was looking back at these many years that we've had the network since 2002 and trying to remember, you know, what are the things that stand out. And I think I can truly say the one meeting that I remember the most, both for the adventure and the fun, was the one in 2009 that we had in Imphal in Manipur. First of all, it was a miracle the way Anjulika, Chitra and the others pulled it off, despite the fact that at the last minute we were informed that there was curfew from 5 a.m. to 5 p.m. From 5 p.m. to 5 a.m. And the fact that, there was difficulties in transport and all kinds of other difficulties. And yet, how amazing that we were all there at the time when Irom Sharmila was released, as she was every year, that we could see her being taken from the hospital. We were waiting at the hospital to the tent where the mothers who had been on a sympathy fast with her were also with her. And apart from the moving thing about that, just being on the spot for that was something so special, but also the fun and the camaraderie. And I think that is what I treasure the most about NWMI. Network is too cold a word. I would say we have developed a family-like feeling, which is very unusual given journalists are so competitive. And we've set an example of how we can build solidarities without falling into the dominant mode of organizations. So all the best to everybody for 2021. Bye-bye.
Hi friends, happy to meet you all, and hats off to the wonderful spirit of NWMI. Okay, now I'm sharing a story with you in 1 minute. Let us sit in a time machine and go back, say, 25 years. The new millennium was yet to start and NWMI was not yet born. And most of you might have been in the kindergarten or schools. So at that time I was in Sakal Papers, Pune. And one afternoon I was waiting for one of my guests and I was sitting at my desk. After some time, a smart, confident lady with short hair appeared dot on time. Guess who she was? I think you have guessed it right. She was Ammu Joseph. She was traveling all over India for her book, Women in Journalism, Making News. And she interviewed 200 women across India. I was one of them. At that time, the book was one of its kind, very different. And that very book floated the idea that, you know, we need some network for women journalists. Then Ammu and others planned some regional meetings in 2000. And soon after that, some local chapters started. Pune was one of them. You know, all of us were feeling that we need something like this. And that is why in Pune, it took roots very fast and it didn't take time for us to, you know, get connected. And if you remember, Pune used to be the biggest group to attain the NWMI meetings, annual meetings. Pune group was different or unique, I'll say, in one sense that all of us in those days were working in the regional language, that is Marathi. And whereas all the other groups, for example, Mumbai, Bangalore or Kolkata, most of them were with English medium, English media. And you can imagine the regional language press at that time and the situation there. So we got a national view because of this group, and other groups got the regional flavor. So really it worked very well, and the inclusiveness and diversity of NWMI was, you know, it was quite attractive and it was still so near and dear to me. We have got so many friends in this wonderful network. If I start taking the names, I'll take at least an hour. So let us sit back into that time machine and now go ahead 25 years. And I'm sure we all will see a more stronger NWMI with more and more chapters attached to it. And with the same spirit of solidarity and the upbeat mood. So I'm really happy and once again salute to the NWMI spirit. Bye.
Hello, this is Linda in Shillong. This is the city where NWMI had its second meeting in 2000. And Ammu Joseph had come here with her book. And it was, she had invited, I think, journalists from all over the country and the region. And it was a great joy to see so many women journalists, because even at that time, there were very few women journalists anywhere in our region. And talking about all the problems of journalism, and particularly how women journalists were faring, it was decided that we needed a platform where women journalists could come together and talk about their problems and how they should do better in their profession, how they should solve the working conditions particularly affecting women. So this is how things started, and there it was decided that there should be a group, and that is how NWMI started rolling. And I'm glad to say that since then, this platform, which doesn't have any real hierarchy or anything like that, but It is something that has grown. It is an organic kind of a group where people, it mostly works on caring and sharing and understanding, which is quite unique. And I know that this kind of group is needed even more now among journalists, because there's so much pressure on our freedoms and on our freedom of expressions and on our writings. And I can say that this onslaught can only be challenged by a group like ours. And that is why we have to strengthen this organization and continue to make it a vehicle of solidarity and a network of trust among us, which will also help journalists who are in other areas, in other groups, who may not have this kind of solidarity. So I say, long live NWMI.
And I, for me, actually, the seeds of the NWMI were laid even earlier in a small little study group kind of which we had formed here in Bombay, and Kalpana and Amu and some of the many of the others used to be there, part of it. Neelan, I remember, had joined us at some point. So we used to meet regularly, and basically what we used to do is to have these discussions on issues that were close to us, which concerned our work and women journalists and women. It used to be, so that was really where we started feeling the need, and we felt that, okay, it'd be good to have such a wider network. And then, of course, Amu met all these women while she was writing her book, and everyone seemed to want to have a network like that. So and that's how this was formed. At the conference that launched the Network of Women in Media in Delhi in 2002, I was the one pushing to have a website, because that's what I had got engaged with. I was in a company which was making websites, and I felt that it would really help this network to have that as a hub. So, and the strange and funny thing is that the one person who was not so keen on it, which was Amu, was the one who really has been the, you know, sort of the person who has kept the website alive. Most of the content has come from her. Of course, anything, all of those who are new to the organization, you may not see the faces of the people behind who organize these events and get them done. But she, Lakshmi, you know, are really two of the very, usually they will be behind every major activity happening in this group. So just, you can take that for granted. I think even this particular meeting is, they played a role. Everyone, a lot of us get together, everybody contributes. That's the great thing about this group. We don't have any, you know, formal structure. We don't have a president and a vice president and treasurer and all that. But we never seem to have a problem with that. We've been having these major conferences every year, and we have found the funding. We have managed to organize it and go ahead and do good work. And I think one of the most wonderful things of this network and the conferences that we used to have, it's just, you feel just rejuvenated. You feel that feeling that you get of a whole so many women who are with you, think like you, and it's a wonderful support structure. And this last year, when we've been having such a bad time, it has been very, very important. So here's cheers to NWMI and to all of you who have joined us recently. Welcome.
Hi. When many years ago, Amu first came to Kolkata and she met many of us and also raised the issue of a network, it was such an exciting idea. It was an idea which I think many of us immediately responded to, because we realized the potential of a media women network and what the potentials can be. Though I hadn't visualized that it would grow at such a, you know, phenomenal pace. I've always been a network person with the women's movement and peace movement, and I realized the advantage of being a member of a network. And therefore, when the network slowly grew over the years, people pitched in silently. It was, you know, many members felt, what is there for me in the network? But, you know, one should question, what do we do for the network? And there are people who have silently worked for the network to strengthen it, to set up the website for all these, support groups, the petitions, to react to all the issues, holding hands, behind the scene activities and consultations. There's a lot of giving of themselves, and one should appreciate how members have done it. The fellowship, setting it up from an idea to getting people to contribute, and people have silently given. You know, and I always think, when now I read your articles in the post, and I think, wow, why didn't I think of that idea? And I'm so excited, and I wish I can write like you and feel like you. I feel so proud to be a member of the network. And I think the last meeting in Bangalore was very revealing for me. You know, it was suddenly done almost overnight. Within a month, the Bangalore team took over because Assam couldn't do it because of the CA movement. But the spirit of the network actually was there in the Bangalore meet, how members rallied around, got us to come, persuaded everyone to be there, getting a wonderful program going, silently working. When we met them, there was no, at least, look of tiredness on their face or saying that, oh my God, we're exhausted. And I think that is the network, how people pitch in even at a very, you know, kind of a tense moment. And it shows how members rise to the occasion. And we see it again during the COVID times. My goodness, the kind of programs our members have done, you know, from jobs online to different kind of discussions, so exciting. I'm sorry I've not been able to participate in all the programs, but I do in many of them, and I'm really amazed at the quality of our speakers and how well they speak. And now we are going through such a terrible political time, the right-wing way, and I feel this network is even more important to us, to support each other, to be there for each other, to have these discussions. Media is such an important political tool. We have to be with the people, and I think even more so the network has a major role to play. I hope to meet all of you in the next meeting, not a virtual one. Thank you so much.